Hey everybody, it's Def Stamina. Welcome back to the third Amiibo tournament. Today is the finale. The finale to the end of the tournament. So we have our six competitors left remaining. We have about six matches we're gonna have to do, but we're gonna go ahead and get immediately into this first round. We got losers bracket semifinals, so this is gonna eliminate two more people right here. So we got the first matchup is between Aura Lord and who's the 3 seed, by the way, and the 5 seed, Captain Ganon. Two very powerful opponents who have done really well. Let's go ahead and pick our stage, and it's going to be Onette. Captain Ganon obviously fell down to loser's bracket following his loss to Super Mario, where he actually stood a pretty good chance up until his second death. He was keeping it pretty close up until he died, and then I kind of just thought, oh yeah, it's over here. Overlord, after taking a loss as well, starting to pick his own game up. He's played very well. I think this is going to be a very close one between straight up power versus kind of like building up power. These two are, they were standing there a little bit. This is their first meeting ever. If I had to make a prediction, I have no idea. Goodness. I don't think I can make a prediction. If I have to though, I'm gonna say Ganon with one stock left. Oh, and he's gonna get the first kill. 102 damage. Captain Ganon was, of course, a rookie coming into this tournament. Was probably the best one out of all of them. And he's barely going to recover. Oh, nice elbow right there. You see, he has very powerful elbows and kicks. Emptying in with 186 damage using his big size to kind of keep him in the stage. Oh, nice kick. Lucario has some great recovery though, so he's going to come back from that. Oh, nice one right there. That's going to put Lucario back over 100 damage. Oh, that's another one. That's going to send him flying a little bit, but he's still going to recover. It avoids that kick. Takes another grab right there. That choke always does a lot of damage for Ganon. Oh, but there's a smash, and it's finally going to send Ganon flying. But Orler with 136 damage. Ganon with a huge lead. You know, Ganon, of course, mentioning about his battle with Super Mario, he literally was in that fight up until he died the second time. That's going to break shields, and he's going to send them flying with the elbow. Yeah, Captain Ganon actually stayed pretty much with Mario. Looks like he was going to at least push him to one stock. But after dying a second time, after failing to grab the ledge, kind of just put it all out the window, and Mario was once again able to win. Powerful kick right there. Ganon's also being very dodgy. He's actually been a little bit more successful at dodging, and that's going to do a lot of damage. Captain Ganon doing a pretty good job. Just needs to get that one more smash attack. Can use one of his stocks if he has to, and he didn't really try to there. He just kind of fell into that attack. But he has one whole stock here to try and finish off Overlord. Oh, that was a good dodge by Overlord. Oh, counter right there. Oh, nice one right there. Overlord at 177. Has to be very careful right now. Oh, broke the shield. This is a chance for Ganon to finish it off, and he does right there. Overlord had a little bit of a storm back there, but Captain Ganon stayed right in control. to finish it off. So Captain Ganon will move on to the Loser's Bracket Finals, which is essentially the fourth place game of the Loser's Bracket, whereas Orlord will go out in the Loser's Bracket Semifinals. That was a very good match by both of them, and Orlord did a pretty good job throughout the tournament. Puts himself in a pretty good position after following his runner-up finish in the second Amiibo tournament. Now we're going to move on to our second match of the Loser's Bracket. They're going to determine who's going to face Captain Ganon. This one is actually pretty exciting. Middle of the group seeds, we got the 8 seed Lonk from Pennsylvania and the 10 seed Terminator. It's going to be very interesting to see how these two go. They're both very attacking people, so let's see how it goes. And we're going to go to Yoshi's Island. So Lonk, of course, had to face Mario in his first, pretty early on, so he got sent down to the Loser's Bracket, but then he immediately stormed through several matches, defeating Super Luigi and Mr. Boozer pretty easily. So now he's got Terminator here, who Terminator has been the upset machine parts of the way. So he started out immediately by, of course, getting kind of an easy one, defeating Deadmau5, but then beat Super Luigi, and then beat DP Man Jr., before finally falling to Mac Daddy D. And then after falling to the Loser's Bracket here, he's just kind of been sitting around. Oh, and Terminator's going to get the very first kill with 83 damage. Terminator might need to get a boost after this one with how good he's performing. Just has to be very careful, because of course Lonk has some great combo abilities. But that's a nice combo there done by Terminator. That's one of his better combos. He also has a shielding ability, which allows him to heal from shield, so Terminator very much in control right now. That's going to send Lonk flying up into the air a little bit. Rob tried to go for that up air combo, but couldn't quite get it. Oh, that's a good hit right there. It's not going to be enough to send Terminator out of the stage yet. Arrow's trying to use it to ruin his recovery. Good hit right there, and that's going to eliminate Lonk again. Terminator with a 2-stock lead now on Lonk. That combo right there does a lot. Not quite enough to eliminate Terminator yet, even at 210. Air combo once again by Terminator. Seriously, one of his best combos. Nice shield for some healing. Oh, that's gonna hurt though. Oh, and there we go. Lonk got the combo off. That'll take care of Terminator's first stock. Oh, that's a good hit. And Lonk is not going to recover from that. I thought he was. I thought he was going to come back right from that, but he went straight to a jump, and that killed him. So Terminator moving on to the Loser's Bracket Finals, basically the fourth place game, as I said, with a 3-1 victory over Lonk. Lonk will be eliminated from the tournament, but a very good performance, making up for his mediocre performance in the last tournament. 3-1. Terminator's going to move on. That's going to be a very interesting bout to see between Captain Ganon and Terminator. So now we're going to move up to the winner's bracket for the winner's bracket finals. Now the way this works is that the winner of that match is going to kind of get a break and gets to sit around until he finds out who emerges from the loser's bracket. Whereas the loser of the match we're about to do will kind of just sit back, see who wins between Ganon and Terminator, and then face them to see if they get a chance to face off against the ultimate winner. So here we go into the bout. We have the 1 seed, the 2-time champion, Super Mario, right here, facing off against the 11 seed, quite the upset, actually, Mr. Upset Man, Comeback Kid, Mac Daddy D. The 11 seed has been pretty much doing nothing but upsets the whole tournament, which is saying something, especially for him. He defeated Orlord in the, he defeated Star Kong in his first match, then beat Hurricane, then beat Overlord, then beat Terminator to get to this match. So he's been fighting pretty much the whole way with some resistance. Let's go and pick out a stage, and it's going to be Kalos Pokemon League. So you get pretty much power versus power right here. It's just whether MechDD is going to use his power a little bit better than Mario. Mario, of course, has been facing some adversity in his matches. He's been having probably the tougher matches, his most toughest matches of he's experienced. But hasn't really been challenged. He did have that close 3-1 performance that was actually a lot closer than it seemed for against Captain Ganon. They had the 3-2 match against Long, so definitely was not missing. Missed that KO right there, MechDD did. Do expect the healing for Super Mario to probably give him a slight advantage. This is close so far. This is very intense. I expect Mario to win this one, but I just want to see how close MechDD does come to ruining it. Oh, he broke Mario's shield. Opportunity. There we go. He finally gets the hit off right as the stun works, but a lot of damage, and he breaks his shield again. Oh, and that's a nice hit, and Mario's going to die first. This is a developing story. MechDD with a little bit of an advantage, but of course, anything can happen with Mario's amazing attack damage. If he gets one nice charge attack, it's going to do a lot of damage. Oh my goodness, Mario's getting his butt kicked. What's going on here? And remember, if you lose here, you're not out of the tournament. You just kind of sit back and you have to fight another person before you get a second chance. But oh, that's a nice hit. Dude, Mario bringing it right back. Opportunities are there. MechDD has his KO ready once again. Oh, he just missed it. Wasn't anywhere near hitting him the first two times, but he hit it that time. Oh, and he breaks Mario's shield again. Another opportunity for MechDD to do some damage. And he KOs him again. Oh boy, this is very interesting. MechDD was given a little bit lower seed just because of his recovery issues, but he hasn't really been challenged that the whole tournament. He's been pretty much on the upper hand the whole time, so he hasn't had to rely on his recovery very much. He's been kicking butt just sitting on the stage. Oh my goodness, this is just ridiculous. Oh, there we go, and MechDD's finally gonna die the first time. Mario still could pull off a comeback. MechDD does have quite a big lead, though. He's gonna be very careful, MechDD does. Because Mario, of course, can land a lot of damage in one nice hit. He doesn't have as much defense as some of the other characters. Oh, dude. Grammar, fix that. Okay. MechDD still with a slight lead, but of course, Mario! That was a nice charge attack, and that's definitely not coming back for MechDD. Super Mario has turned it around here. Oh, be very careful. Be very, very careful, Mario. Oh my goodness, this is going to be very interesting. If MechDD can, even if he loses... Oh, there's a broken shield. Oh, nice punch. Still not enough to eliminate Mario yet. And he doesn't recover! Oh my goodness, it's an up this set of the century. Of course, leave it to MechDD to do it. Mr. Little Mac comeback kid. Little Mac from Punch-Out. MechDD delivers Super Mario his first loss on camera. That is amazing. He hadn't lost a long while prior to that. He lost in tournament history, so that's amazing. MechDD is going to move on and get quite a nice break from a tournament, and we'll wait to see who moves on and who he gets to face off. Super Mario suffering that loss, but he still has a chance to win the tournament and defend his championship abilities. He will just be sitting back in the loser's bracket. He's going to wait the winner of Terminator and Captain Ganon to see if he can come back and get that rematch against MechDD. Let's go ahead and skip past that. Oh my goodness, that was amazing. I can't wait to see what's going to develop now after that result. So now we're going to move on back down to our loser's bracket, and we're going to go ahead and see who will win between Terminator and Captain Ganon. So let's go ahead and get him on the pedestals here. Captain Ganon versus Terminator. Go ahead and pick out the stage. going to be Willy Castle. I think Captain Ganon would like no more than to just get another match against Super Mario, but Terminator has been performing so well, it could be a big challenge. So remember, the winner here will go on to face Super Mario, and the loser will essentially get fourth place in the tournament. Right now, Terminator has the lead. I believe this is these guys' second meetup, so they're not quite used to each other yet. Game is starting to get up for both guys right now. Terminator with a slight lead. Trying to open it up a little bit, actually. He's going to have a little bit of trouble trying to knock out Ganon. Ganon's about as heavy as Boozer is. So it's going to be pretty tough for his for him to get the KOs. Oh, and there's the elbow right there, and Ganon's going to get the first kill despite 201 damage. Nice job done there by Captain Ganon. And recovery is definitely nowhere near enough. Definitely nowhere near enough. Captain Ganon's out, and we're back to even terms on the second stock. Can't tell in the tone of my voice, I'm a little giddy after that result of MacDAD beating Super Mario. That is pretty amazing. Tell you what, even if MacDAD doesn't win this tournament, that's pretty big. That's Super Mario's first loss in a tournament, or pretty much since he was gotten. Oh, Captain Ganon broken the shield there. He's gonna destroy him right there. Nice job at Captain Ganon. But yeah, Mario had not lost a single match, I mean, up until... And you can't really qualify his the 8-Man Smash's losses. He pretty much survived the whole way through to win in the later matches. So he didn't really finish under the bottom half of that 8-Man Smash. So he didn't necessarily lose in that situation. So, but you might as well say in 1v1 matches, he is undefeated. So MacDAD did something big there. Of course, it's going to be very interesting to see if Mario can come back and probably get a rematch. And remember, in this, in the way that the the final elimination, as Captain Ganon will win 3-1, and he will face off against Super Mario and get his rematch. But anyway, as I was saying, MacDAD, the person who advances from the loser's bracket is going to have to beat MacDAD twice, you know, to make up for the double elimination, because MacDAD would have to lose twice, whereas the other person would only have to lose once. So it's going to be very interesting, but Captain Ganon, he's going to move on, eliminate Terminator. Terminator's going to get fourth place. Very proud of him. That's actually a very good performance for him. I've not seen him do that well, really, in any tournament, but that's nice. He did pretty well. To see Terminator, he got, of course, got like, I believe he got fourth place in the second Amiibo tournament, too, but now, I guess I've been underestimating him, but we remove Terminator. Now we're going to add Super Mario as his opponent. So this is the third place game. The winner will go on to face MacDaddy D. I'm going to pick out the stage. It's going to be Mario Galaxy. Why, of course, it has to be a Mario stage. Watch Mario win it and come back. It's going to face MacDaddy D in two Mario stages in a row. But talking about that battle between MacDaddy D and Super Mario, MacDAD took advantage of breaking Mario's shield to pretty much get his way. That's how he'd been winning most of his matches already. And even though Mario gets healing from shielding, getting it broken is definitely not good. And that's what MacDAD has been doing to competitors all tournament. Oh, he broke. Ganon broke his shield right there. He's gonna elbow him, and Captain Ganon is gonna hit Super Mario out first. You know, this is definitely the most challenge that Mario has been facing in his entire, appearance as an Amiibo. It's almost ridiculous. If Captain Ganon could beat him, I would love to see a Captain Ganon MacDaddy D final. That would be one of the most brilliant finals, and we might see a passing of the torch in some regard. Oh, and Captain Ganon immediately with another stock kill with 188 damage. possibilities are there for Captain Ganon to possibly turn this whole tournament up on its head and send Super Mario out in third instead of second. Captain Ganon goes flying right there. 285 damage, still alive. Oh, but that kicks right there, finally eliminate him. See, Mario can still bring it back. He has 24 damage, and you know how well he can easily take two stocks off of some competitors. The way Captain Ganon's playing, it'd be very interesting to see a rookie win it, but oh, there goes Mario up into the air. Oh, and he eliminated him! Oh my goodness! Not once, but twice, the double whammy! That's amazing. The double whammy, 3-1! And look at that, Captain Ganon is going to send Mario out with two straight losses, and Mario is going to take third place, so that was completely not what I was expecting. Not at all in that result, but with that win, it'll now be Captain Ganon versus Mac Daddy D for the third Amiibo tournament finale. That is absolutely ridiculous. Let's go ahead and get Mac Daddy D up onto the pedestal here. So remember here, Captain Ganon has to beat Mac Daddy D twice in order to win the tournament. Mac Daddy D just has to beat Captain Ganon once. So that's how the tournament is going to, is how it's going to finish up. So this is why I said it's going to be 6 or 7. Six stages, Woohoo Island. I am looking so forward to this match, you have no idea. I was so prepared for a Mario being part of the finale. I was expecting a Mario Little Mac finale, but now seeing it's Little Mac and Ganon is definitely interesting. It definitely brings a change out for once. Mac Daddy D hasn't really faced a lot of challenge from his recovery being an issue, which is very good. He hasn't had to have that issue really face him. Of course, he hasn't been facing anyone that has done a lot of big smash attacks on him. He's been kind of keeping himself on the stage. He's going to have his work cut out against Captain Ganon, who's one of the tougher people to knock out. He has a lot of power. Oh, nice punch there by Mac Daddy D. His KO is ready, and I don't think Ganon's going to recover from that, and he's not. So Mac Daddy D with the immediate lead. Crouch over the ledge, just like looking, like, oh, how did he die? Did he crash into the beach or something? Did he crash into that tree? Did he crash into a mountain? It's hilarious. Oh, but that elbow right there is not hilarious. Captain Ganon tired of Mac Daddy D's crap and puts it back to even terms on the second stock. Big dodge there by Captain Ganon gives him a slight lead now. Oh, nice punch there by Mac Daddy D. His KO is ready. He can use it. I think he's just waiting for the right time to use it. Oh, nice uppercut right there. He's giving Captain Ganon a run for his money right now. He's going to lose his KO right there, and he's not going to recover. So, Captain Ganon with a slight lead. Oh my goodness, it's going to be amazing for whoever wins this. And Captain Ganon is not going to recover, so we're back to even ground on the last dock. We're coming down to a very close finish. Tell you what, I'm super excited, but Mac Daddy gets an immediately big lead. Captain Ganon not going to allow him to try to do any edge guarding there. Oh, that's going to send Captain Ganon off the ledge a little bit. And is he going to recover? Oh, not if Mac Daddy D stops him. And no, Ganon is not going to recover. And so Mac Daddy D is the winner. That belt does look good on you, little Mac. It looks amazing on you, little Mac. Mac Daddy D. Oh my goodness. What a tournament for the ages. That was only the third one, but it was exciting. That now he deserves to wear that belt, because Mac Daddy D is your third Amiibo tournament champion. Captain Ganon putting up a very valiant performance, especially defeating Super Mario in that third place game. To get second place, Mario will take third, and Terminator will take fourth. So, what a finish to the third Amiibo tournament. Now we have some variety in our champions. Mario didn't just storm away with the victory this time. But to go ahead and sum up now, after this tournament has been completed, my next upload schedule, I'm probably going to do a video of the Super Luigi Bros that I did on a Twitch stream before, on DP Man's channel. I'm probably going to do a pretty long video of that and just do like a big long hour long marathon or whatever of that. Then we're going, me and DP Man are going to resume the Mario Party 2, complete the boards for that, and then we will go on to a fourth Amiibo tournament where we will do the single elimination. So far, from what I've been hearing, the double elimination has been everyone's favorite, but of course we need to see the single elimination, just see if that would be any more convenient or any more fun for the rest of the viewers. But that's going to do it for the tournament. That was an amazing finish, and I'm definitely not going to forget it. That was pretty funny and pretty exciting, the way that everything just fell down. But that's going to do it. I've been Def Stamina. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.